Hello friends, in this video we are going to study how to convert a decimal number to binary number, especially how to convert a floating point decimal number to binary number. Consider this example where we have given 28.125, a number 28.125 decimal to binary, means we have to convert this number to binary. The first thing that we have to see is, in the given number there are two parts. One is called integral part, which appears before the decimal point, whereas after decimal point we have fractional part. We are going to apply a different procedure to convert an integral part to binary, whereas we are going to apply some another procedure to convert this fractional part to binary. So these two methods are completely different. So we'll first see how to convert this integral part decimal number to binary. To convert the first 28 to binary, we are going to follow this procedure. Will prepare a structure for division. This is quotient, and then we have remainders. We are going to successfully divide this given decimal number by 2 till the quotient becomes 0, and for each and every step we are going to write the remainders aside. So first of all we divide 28 by 2. So the quotient becomes 14, whereas remainder for this step is 0. Now again we divide this 14 by 2, the quotient becomes 7 and the remainder for this step is 0. We divide this 7 by 2 again, your quotient becomes 3, remainder is 1 for this step. We divide this 3 by 2, so your quotient becomes 1 and remainder is also 1. In the last step we divide this 1 by 2 and here your quotient becomes 0 and the remainder is as it is. So we'll stop our division process when we get the quotient as 0. So all the remainders we got here. So the last remainder that we got is called MSB bit, most significant bit, whereas the first remainder is called as LSB bit in this process. To obtain the binary equivalent for this decimal number, we have to arrange these remainders from bottom to this way. So I can say that 28 decimal is equivalent to 11100 in binary. In fractional part now we'll apply a different procedure to convert the fractional part decimal number to binary. So the fractional part given in the number was 0.125. Here for the fractional part we multiply the given fractional part by 2 and we get the result, that is 0.250. Okay, we get the result for this multiplication as 0.250. From this result we record the integral part. Just pick the integral part and record it here. The integral part was 0 for this result, and we carry forward this remaining fractional part 0.250 for the further step, and we again multiply it by 2. This process continued till your fractional part becomes 0, or we solve this example up till 3 decimal places. So for this multiplication 0.250 into 2, we get the result as 0.500. From this we again record this integral part. So here it is, and we carry forward this 0.500 for the further multiplication. Here we get the result as 1.000. Okay, so from this integral part, from the result we record 1 and we carry forward this fractional part. So we got 0.000. you multiply, you get 0.000. You can say that you can stop it here also. Whenever you get fractional part 0, it means you come to an end of this multiplication process. So here also we can say the integral part is 0. In this case, the MSB bit is the first bit that we have recorded, and LSB bit is this one, because I will stop here only. If you multiply any number to 0, you get 0. So this is our result, last bit. So this is LSB bit here, and we have to go from top to bottom to obtain the binary equivalent for the given decimal number. That is, so I can say that 0.125 decimal is equivalent to 0.001 in binary. Now to get our actual result for the given number, that is 28.125 in decimal, we have to combine the result of both the sections, integral part as well as fractional part. We got the result of integral part as 11100, that is our 28, right? And this is the result of fractional part, so we'll put it after this decimal point, 0.001. So we combined integral part result as well as fractional part result to get our actual result of the binary. So this is our output. This is a given decimal number which has both the parts, integral part as well as fractional part. We have seen the procedure how to convert integral part to binary, whereas how to convert fractional part to binary, and at last we need to merge integral part result as well as fractional part result to get our binary equivalent. Hello friends, in this video we are going to study how to convert a decimal number to octal number. Consider this number, that is 28.125 decimal is given to us to convert it to octal. Hello, the given number has two parts. The first part of this number is called as integral part, and the other part is called as fractional part. The part which appears before the decimal point is called integral part, and the part which appears before the decimal point is called as fractional part. So we are going to apply a different procedure to convert this decimal number to octal, whereas fractional part, another procedure we are going to apply to get it into octal. So we'll see the procedure how to convert 28 decimal to binary. This is our integral part. So this is the remainder. We are going to divide this decimal number by 8 successively, because we want to convert it into octal. So whenever you want to convert it, any decimal number to octal, you have to divide the given decimal number by 8 successively. So the quotient will be written in this line, whereas the remainders of each and every step will be written into the remainder column. So whenever you divide 28 by 8, the quotient becomes 3, whereas the remainder for this procedure step is 4. Again, you try to divide this 3 by 8, the quotient becomes 0 because it is not divisible, and the remainder as it is into the remainder column. So 3 goes into remainder column. So this is the remainder of the last step. This is our MSB bit, and this is the LSB bit. MSB bit is most significant bit, this is less significant bit. To get the octal equivalent for this decimal number 28, we have to arrange these remainders from bottom to top. For integral part, we have to apply this procedure. So therefore I can say that 28 decimal is equals to 3/4 in octal. Now we'll see the procedure for converting any decimal number having fractional part to octal. the fractional part given in the problem was 0.125. We will multiply this fractional part by 8 in every step. We get some result here. So result for this step is 1.000, and we will going to record the integral part from the result. The integral part is 1, so we'll record 1 here, and we'll carry forward the fractional part for further multiplication. So the next calculation is 0.00 into 8. We get this. We'll record this 0. We'll continue this process till your fractional part becomes 0. But in our first step itself, we got our fractional part as 0. It means this is our answer for this fractional part. So this is MSB bit. This is LSB bit. For fractional part, we'll arrange the data from top to bottom. So I can say that 0.125 decimal is equals to 0.10 in octal, or we can say that 0.1 in octal. So we can discard this 0 because it is coming after a decimal point. This and this, both the numbers are same. To obtain our result, that is 28.125 decimal to octal, we need to combine both the parts, results of both the parts, integral part as well as fractional part. The result of integral part was 34, and the fractional part result is 1.1. So this is our final result for this problem. We have converted 28.125 decimal to octal, and the octal equivalent for this number is 34.1. Thank you. Hello friends, in this problem we are going to convert a decimal number to an hexadecimal number. Consider this example given to us, that is 28.125 decimal to hexadecimal. The given number has two parts. One is called as integral part, the part which appears before decimal point, and the part which appears before after decimal point. The part which appears before decimal point is called as integral part, whereas the part which appears after decimal point is called as fractional part. So there is a different procedure to convert this integral part to hexadecimal and fractional part to hexadecimal. Now we'll first see how to convert this integral part to hexadecimal. The given number to us is 28. We successfully divide this given number by 16 because we want to convert this decimal number to hexadecimal numbers. Hexadecimal number system base is 16. So that's why we have to divide it by 16. So when you divide this number by 28 by 16, your quotient becomes 1, right? Whereas the remainder is 12. Then again, try to divide this 1 by 16. Here your quotient becomes 0, whereas remainder is 1. Now how to convert this 12 into hexadecimal? Hexadecimal number system has valid digits from 0 to 15, right? So the digits from 0 to 9, and then for 10 we have alphabet A, for 11 we have alphabet B, for 12 we have alphabet C, 13 is D, 14 is E, and 15 is F. So what is this 12? 12 is C. So how do you represent 12 in hexadecimal? By alphabet C. So this is equivalent to C. This is our MSB bit last, whereas this is LSB bit. To get the hexadecimal equivalent for this number 28, we arrange this data from MSB to LSB. Therefore, I can say that 28 decimal is equals to 1C in hexadecimal, or it is also written as 1C to the base capital H, 16 or capital H. Both are equivalent. I will see the procedure for converting a fractional part to hexadecimal. In this problem, the fractional part given was 0.125. So we'll copy it here. It means we have to convert this 0.125 decimal to hexadecimal. Okay. In this case, we'll multiply this fractional part, that is 0.125, by 16. And in the result column, we get the result for this multiplication as 2.000. We record the integral part from this result, that is 2 here, and we carry forward the fractional part for the further multiplication. And in the next step, we'll get the result again. 16 into 0 is 000. So we record here the bits. We'll continue this process till your fractional part becomes 0. But in the first step itself, we got the fractional part. We can stop here itself our process. So in this case, this is our MSB bit, whereas this is LSB bit. To get the hexadecimal equivalent for this given decimal number, we have to arrange this data from top to bottom. Therefore, I can say that 0.125 decimal is equivalent to 0.2 in hexadecimal. To get the actual result of our problem, we need to combine both the parts, that is 28.125 decimal is equivalent to, the result of the first part was 1C, just copied here, 1C point. The result of the second part, that is 0.2, so which comes after this decimal point. So this is our actual answer. So 28.125 decimal is equals to 1C 0.2 hexadecimal.